This device is becoming popular nowadays. It's a wireless charger or Qi charger. It allows you to charge your mobile phone or another device wirelessly without connecting it directly to the charger. The system has two parts, a receiver and a transmitter. This is the receiver and you connect it into your phone like this. And you can stick it here, or you can even put it under your cover. You can remove the cover of your phone, put it underneath, and it can be hidden inside like this. The only problem is that you can't use your USB port anymore. You can't charge it normally now, and you can't connect it to your computer for data transfer or so. This one is the transmitter. There is the pad, the cable, and some manual. A very simple one. If you want to read it, you can stop the video for a while. And this cable goes here, and this one just goes into any USB charger. So let's test it. Wait, it doesn't fit. Unfortunately, it seems like the hole in the plastic just doesn't line up with the connector, so I'm not able to stick it in. That's disappointing. I have bought it separately on eBay. The transmitter was $1.50 including shipping, and the receiver was $1 including shipping. And it seems like I will have to open it first and then test it. So let's try to open it and fix the connector. There is some rubber band or ring on it, but there are probably no screws underneath. So I probably have to just pry open it like this. No screws in it. There is some LED. That's weird because there is just no hole or light guide for the LED, so what's the point of this LED? Where the light comes out from this? That's weird. There is some board with the connector, some components on it, and this pad. It's a coil. This is, it's a ferrite pad. That's possible. That's probably to increase the inductance of this one. So there is some LED, the connector, and some other components, two chips for transistors, some capacitors, resistors, diode, and so. And there is a screw that just came out without screwing. That's nice. There are 10 turns of a wire. It's quite a thick wire with strange insulation. It looks like fabric. This one actually looks like a small induction heater or cooker. The chips are LM324 and some other chip I don't know. And there are 4 transistors, probably in a bridge, and they probably drive the coil. So let's try to fix the problem. There is a hole for this screw, but they didn't even bother to tighten it. So let's put it properly into the place. and tighten the screw. This is not the best tool for it, of course. But now it's tightened. Now I can plug it in properly. So let's try to put it all back together and let's see. Now let's try to power it up using this USB monitor and this charger. Here we are going to see the voltage and the current. So we can see how much does it draw and what is the voltage. And it draws 40 milliamps, or it actually changes. It seems like it tries to detect some receiver repeatedly. When I put the receiver to it, it goes up to about 500 milliamps. So let's try to stick it into a phone. And now it draws, it actually charges and it draws about 1.2 amps. Now the current goes up to about 1.4 amps. That's quite a lot, and you can't use a 1 amp charger. You have to use a 2 amp charger like this one. And the receiver is, well, getting quite hot, and the transmitter is also a little bit hot. Now it's 1.5 amps. It seems to be cooking my phone like an induction heater or induction cooker, because now it's 1.5. And when I put it like this, without the phone on it, it goes down to about... It actually dies? No. It goes down to about 0.4 amps. That's weird. The current really is quite random, and the charger is getting really quite hot, and I think I can smell something. Oh. There seems to be some component in the receiver overheating and melting through its cover. That's nice. And this overheating component even made a mark on my phone here. So it's, well, quite disappointing, and I think there's time to take a look inside. It seems to be made of just something like a sticky tape. It's just a foil, a very thin foil made of plastic with some adhesive on it. Here you can see the hole burned through it. So there is something that overheated. Not sure, is it a resistor or diode? And there is the coil. What's this one? Is it a very thin layer of ferrite? Not sure. Yes, it is magnetic, so it must be something like a ferrite. So this one must be the core of the coil. The coil is made of two wires in parallel, and there is the board with a lot of components. There are six transistors, two 6-pin chips, one 8-pin chip, two diodes, an inductor, and a lot of capacitors and resistors. This 8-pin chip has no marking on it, and maybe you can see the marking of the other components. if you want to look for the data sheet, and there are no other components from the other side. Now let's try to do some measurements. I will stick it to the pad so it doesn't move, like this. Let's plug it in, plug it into my phone. I hope it's not gonna burst into flames now. It's charging. And now what is the output voltage? About 4.5. A little bit low, but still works. It draws about 1 amp now. And now the question is, what is the charging current? So I've put some longer wires on it to be able to make some measurements. Let's plug it in. Now it draws about 1 amp and it's charging. Now the output voltage is about 4.68 volts. So the voltage at the input and at the output is almost the same. And the current is 1 amp, and let's measure the output current. I will cut it here. And I will put my current meter in series, set to amps. So the input current is now about almost 1 amp, and the output current is about 0.45 amps. So this is less than 50% efficiency. It's more like 45% efficiency. It's not the best, especially nowadays when everybody is chasing for the best possible efficiency. Now the question is, what is the operating frequency? Let's try to measure it wirelessly. Here I've got my frequency meter. I have connected it to a coil with a resistor in series just for the case. And let's put it close to it. And I get some reading, and it shows 122 kHz. So the frequency is about what I expected. So here are some data on it I have written down, and the efficiency is less than half. And this is in the best possible condition, so it's zero distance and a very good alignment. If there is a distance in between, even just few millimeters, the efficiency is going to be much lower. But the biggest problem still remains this burning component inside, which made a hole through the cover here. And according to this picture, you are supposed to put it inside your phone, under the cover. Like this. So think about it. You are supposed to put it here and press it against your lithium-ion battery. So this steaming hot component is pressing directly on your lithium-ion battery. So this is just completely insane. And everybody knows that lithium-ion batteries are flammable, so this is going to set your phone on fire. And if you are not around, ready with your fire extinguisher to put it out, the entire house can be on fire in a few minutes. So, to sum it up, you have a transmitter which you have to fix yourself before you are able to plug the cable in, and you have a receiver which is going to set you on fire. I'm not sure how you guys, but I'm probably going to stick to my old school cable. So this is Diagon Wild, and see you in my next videos.